There's a renewed push for information tonight by attorneys representing a Louisville man accused of 8 murders. Andy Alcock joins us live in the newsroom with the latest details in the case against Ricky Kelly. Andy?
Rick, Kelly's attorneys had several pretrial motions heard in court today. One major claim is they're not being provided information about witnesses expected to testify against Kelly. But they said in court today they have been told about 2 of those witnesses who are already in prison, including one man who took a plea deal. Francois Cunningham is currently serving a 10-year prison sentence, and it could turn out to be less time if he cooperates with prosecutors. Cunningham was accused of shooting and burning 2 people to death. But after his first capital murder trial ended in a hung jury, Cunningham pleaded guilty to 2 counts of manslaughter, arson, and tampering with physical evidence. Now, Amy Hanna says Cunningham has agreed to testify against her client, Ricky Kelly, who's accused of 8 murders. But Hanna says prosecutors have other yet-to-be-named witnesses.
If I knew what they had, I might not have to ask for it. What the Commonwealth has said is there are 15 to 20 of these cooperators. We don't have that information.
But prosecutors pointed to discovery or evidence sealed from the public in the court file. Hanna argued some of it has been sealed improperly without a court order. Judge Irv Mays has ordered all the evidence in the case released publicly April 1st.
To my knowledge, we've turned over every written agreement we have. There are, I expect, some that are captured up within the court's order that's set to expire April 1st. I don't know what else to tell her than that.
It's our belief when we come in here April 1st, Commonwealth should come in with a stack of documents for us. However, that is separate and distinct from what they are doing now.
We have public safety and we have adverse publicity. And those, either one of those could be used alone to seal.
We shouldn't have to come in here begging and pleading to get information we are entitled to and that they're under an obligation to turn over.
I have every intention of releasing every document that's contained, so everybody needs to take whatever steps they need to take.
Judge Irv Mays says his goal is to make sure defense attorneys get all the information they need and to keep the case on track for a July trial date. Live in the newsroom, Andy Alcock, WLKY News.